Good morning, students. So today we are back with exercise 1.1, which we have continued from the last lectures. Now here, what we have seen in the last lecture, that is we have seen the properties flexive, symmetric, and consistent of the relation. Okay, when we see the flexive relation, if AA belongs to R, for every A belongs to B. So now the question number 5. From our textbook is, if a relation R is equal to all those elements AB, where A is less than equal to BQ, in the set of real number R. So here, capital A is equal to R, and relation R is defined as AB, where A is less than equal to BQ. Now the question is, we have to check, is the relation is flexive, symmetric, and transitive? So for this, what we have to do? First, the reflexive relation. So for reflex, we have to consider any element which is of type A, comma A. So here, I have considered 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. So let me see what can be 1 by 2 cube. So 1 by 2 cube is 8. And as we know that 1 by 2 is not less than 1 upon 8. Okay, so R is not reflexive. So first is the not reflexive. Second, now symmetric. So for symmetric, what's the condition we have? If AB belongs to R, that will give us that BA belongs to R. So this property must be satisfied. So let me see, and we consider any element of A, comma B which is belongs to R. So here I consider minus 3, comma minus 2, which is belongs to R. As minus 3 is less than minus 1 cube, that is minus 1. So obviously minus 3, comma minus 1 is belongs to R, because it satisfies the condition of the relation. A is less than or equals to B. But for the reverse element, that is B, comma A, what is B here? Minus 1. So minus 1, comma minus 3. So minus 3 cube, that is minus 27. And minus 1 is not less than minus 27. We know that. Therefore, minus 1, comma minus 3 does not belong to R. So here we get that minus 3, comma minus 1 belongs to R. But minus 1, comma minus 3 does not belong to R. So therefore, R is not symmetric. Okay, only one element we can find from an R which is not satisfied the property, then we cannot say generally that it is true. So here we have find one element. You can find out many more elements like this. Then, transitive. So what is the condition for the transitive? If you have an element A, comma B and B, comma C which is belongs to R, then it will give us that AC belongs to R. Okay. A, B and AC belongs to R. So first we have to take in a pair which is type of AB, comma BC. So here I consider 3 and 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 and 6 by 5. These two elements are belongs to R. So here, let me check, is it belongs to R? So we check the condition. A less than or equals to BQ. So let me check 3. Now 3 by 2 cube, that is 27 by 8, and it is 3.37. So obviously 3 is less than 3.37. So 3 comma 3.3 by 2 belongs to R. Second, 3 by 2 is 6 by 5. So 6 by 5 cube, that is 216 by 125. That is, we can calculate, it is 1.72. And 3.3 by 2 is, we know that 1.5. 1.5 is less than 1.72. Therefore, 3 and 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 comma 6 by 5 goes to R. Now, so the next element, that is A comma C. A comma C. So what is A here, students? 3. And what is C? 6 upon 5. So let me check for the 3 comma 6 upon 5. Now we know that 6 by 5 cube. Here we calculate 1.72. And we know that 3 is not less than 1.72. It is greater than. So 3 comma 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 comma 6 by 5 belongs to R, but 3 comma 6 by 5 does not belong to R. Therefore, R is not non-zero. So the answer is, the relation defined in the relation is not reflexive, not symmetric, and not transitive. Now we will see the next question. Now, the next question is depend on the real solution. Now, all the other questions which you will see, in the, all of the questions we have to check the given relation is equivalence or not. So, for this, I have given you the definition also. That what is an equivalence relation? I have written it so many times. So, it is clear to you now that a relation which is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, it is called an equivalence relation. So, students, whenever in the exam they ask the question, prove that the given relation is an equivalence relation or not, you have to prove it is a reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. If any one of the property will not hold, then it is called, it is not an equivalence relation. So, for this, the question number 7 you can check. The question number 7 is, show that the relation R in a set A of all the books in the library of a college given by R is equal to all those X, Y, where X and Y have same number of pages. Show that the given relation is an equivalence relation. Now students, here the set A is the set of all the books in the library. Now X and Y will go to the library, or you know the books. So the relation is given as X and Y have same number of pages. Now first is a reflexive. So obviously X belongs to R, because if you have a same book, then same book having the same number of pages. If you consider one book and that book is the same page with itself, so therefore XX will belong to R, so therefore it is a reflexive. Now, second is a symmetric. For the symmetric thing, what do we call it? If X and Y belongs to R, then Y, X belongs to R. Okay, so now you can see XY belongs to R. So X and Y have same number of pages. Obviously, two books having the same number of pages, then if you consider X or Y or Y or X, both are equal. So that means Y and X have the same number of pages, and then it gives us that Y, X belongs to R. Therefore, R is symmetric. Now, I hope that this is clear to you what is symmetric. Now, transitive. Transitive means we have considered the three books from the library. First book and the second book having the same number of pages. Second and third having the same number of pages. Now obviously, if three books we are collecting, which having the same number of pages, then first and third having the same number of pages. So here we have considered this library in numerical form. X, Y, and Z. So X, Y, and Y, Z belongs to R. That means X and Y and Y and Z have the same number of pages. Now X, Y, and Y, Z have the same number of pages. And obviously X and Z have the same number of pages. That means X and Z belongs to R. Therefore R is transitive. So here we have checked that R is reflexive, symmetric, and the transitive. Therefore, R is an equivalence relation. So this is the first equation based on the equivalence relation, and it is very easy for you because the equation is very easy. You can see X, Y, where X and Y have the same number of pages. So it is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. And as all the three properties are satisfied, therefore it is an equivalence relation. This is the equation we can take the important in the board exam also, in the respect of the board exam. This is the one equation which we have to consider. But type of the equation is easy for the understanding. I hope you very well understand what is an equivalence relation. Okay, so let me see the next equation. 2.1 is the element AR, sorry, the set A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the relation R defined on A is AB, where A minus B is equal. Now R is equals to, we have considered the element first. Let me see the equation, the whole question from the textbook. Show that the relation R in a set A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, given by R is equals to AB, where A minus B is even, is an equivalence relation. Show that all the elements of 1, 3, and 5 are related to each other, and all the elements of set 2, 4 is related to each other, but no element of 1, 3, and 5 is related to 2, 2, 4. So, before going to the second equation, we will see first. The first part of the A is to show that R is an equivalence relation. So now for the equivalence relation, first we have generated, this is not that much important, but when the very less amount in the element in A, in that case we will derive our relation R first. So I will derive this 1, 1, 1, 3 and 1, 5, 2, 2 and 2, 4. When I consider 3, then 3, 1, 3, 3 and 3, 5. When I consider 4, then 4, 4 and 4, 2, 5 and 5, 1, 5, 3 and 5, 5. So now here, why I have written like this? You know that the difference of the odd numbers are always even. Difference of an even numbers is always even. But the difference of odd and even number is odd. So that's why I have considered this one. Now let me see here, let's see. Every A belongs to R, as A minus A is 0, and therefore R is a reflexive. Second, symmetric, so here A I have taken general, but you can take from this also, that here 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, and 5, 5. This is belongs to R, and therefore it is reflexive. Now symmetric, we know the property symmetric. If AB belongs to R, then EA must belong to R. So I have taken this one also in the general, that A minus B is even. If difference of A and B is even and modulus is there, then obviously B minus A is also even, because modulus will use as a positive value. If modulus is not there, then also it is an even number, because it is only the negative of nature. Therefore, BA belongs to R, therefore R is symmetric. If you want to show from this, then you can check that 3, 1, sorry, 1, 3 is there, then 3, 1, then 1, 5, then 5, 1, then 2, 4, then there is 4, 2, 4, 2, then 3, 5, then 5, 3. You can check the all the elements AB and BA are there in a R. So therefore it is symmetric. Now next, that the transitive. Now for the transitive, we also have the property. AB and BC belongs to R, then AC belongs to R. Okay, so let me see A and B, AB, that is A minus B is an even number. Modulus of B minus C is an even number. So when you consider modulus of A minus C, so what can be A minus C? A minus C plus B minus C. So students, you can check, if we can remove this modulus from the A minus B, then it will be positive or negative, what is even number? B minus C, if we remove the modulus, then it will be the even number. So A minus B is even and B minus C is also even, if we are not putting the modulus there. So therefore, when we take A minus C, then it is a difference of A minus B and B minus C, which is even number and even number. And sum of the even number is even number. So therefore, A minus C is an even number. So that means AC belongs to R. Therefore, R is transitive. Is it clear to you? Then what is a transitive? So from here also we can check. 1, 3, and D5, then 1, 5 belongs to R. If 2, 4, and 4 only there, so no need to check for this. Then 3, 1, and 1, 5. 3, 1, and 1, 5. Then 3, 5. So 3, 5 is here. So you can check for every element. So we are not checking for each and every element. We will check the generally. So here, 3 elements, A, B, and B, C belongs to R, then A, C belongs to R. So here R is transitive. So now as R is transitive, so what we got? Then R is reflexive, R is symmetric, R is transitive, therefore R is an equivalence relation. So therefore, first part is true, that our given relation is an equivalence relation. Now the next equation is, every element of the set 1, 3 and 5 is related to the element of the set 1, 3 and 5. So here we can directly check as, or here you can write down the notes as well. So further we may know as, difference of odd numbers is always even, therefore 1, 3 and 5 is related to every element of, or I can write related to each other. Okay. And difference of even numbers is always even, therefore all element of the set 2, 4 is related to each other. So and as is no element of 1, 3, 5 related to 2, 4, for writing this I am taking this portion. So you can note down this on this whole equation in your notebook. The further the last part is a singular one, you can write down by yourself also. As the difference of odd and even number is always an odd number, therefore no element of 1, 3 and 5 is related to the element 2, 4. Okay, so here I should write down the last one. This is the first, second and the third. As difference of odd and even numbers is always odd, therefore no element of 2, 4 is related to the set 1, 3 and 5. So this is the equation number 8 is over. Now you can understand what is an equivalence relation, and further something asked, then please mention in your answer what is it. Okay, how it is related to each other. Okay, or you can write down from the relation, you can directly find that 1 is related to 1, 3, 1, 1, 1, 3 and 1, 5. 4, 3 and 5 is similar, so therefore 1, 3 and 5 is related to each other. Okay, so this is the answer for your question number 8.